For centuries, canals have reshaped our world. They've changed coastlines, redirected rivers, and altered the very patterns of global trade. The Suez Canal linked the Mediterranean with the Red Sea, opening a direct route to Asia. The Panama Canal united the Atlantic and Pacific, redefining maritime travel and commerce. Now, a new proposal is emerging, one that could transform the heart of Eurasia. It's a 700-kilometer waterway, connecting the Caspian Sea to the Black Sea. Backed by Russia, Kazakhstan, and potentially China, this $20 billion project could give landlocked Central Asia a gateway to the world's oceans. And if built, it wouldn't just be another canal. It would be a new maritime corridor with the power to shift trade routes and political influence across an entire continent. Please take a moment to subscribe and like the video. It really helps the channel. The Caspian Sea is the world's largest inland body of water. It holds immense reserves of oil, natural gas, and grain, and its surrounding nations rely on these resources as economic lifelines. But the Caspian has one major problem. It has no natural outlet to the world's oceans. Every shipment of grain, steel, or petroleum must pass through neighboring countries to reach global markets. The only maritime route available today is the Volga-Don Canal, completed in 1952 under Soviet rule. At just 3.5 meters deep and restricted to ships of around 5,000 tons, it simply cannot accommodate the size of modern cargo vessels. Traffic is slow, seasonal, and heavily regulated. It has become a bottleneck that costs exporters billions every year and limits the competitiveness of Caspian economies. Kazakhstan, in particular, has long been constrained by this dependency. Despite being one of the world's top grain producers, it cannot easily export at scale without negotiating access through other states. For a region with abundant resources but limited access, the lack of a deep water route has shaped its economic reality for decades. When Kazakhstan gained independence in 1991, the nation suddenly found itself with vast land, energy wealth, and strategic geography, but no coastline. President Nursultan Nazarbayev believed that this lack of direct access to global shipping held the young nation back. He imagined a future where Kazakhstan could reach the sea on its own terms, without relying on transit routes controlled by others. By 2007, Kazakhstan formally proposed the idea of a deep water canal to Russia. This came at a decisive moment. China had just launched the Belt and Road Initiative, a sweeping plan to reshape trade across Eurasia through railways, pipelines, and seaports. A new canal connecting the Caspian to the Black Sea fit perfectly into this rising network. The proposal aligned the interests of three major players. Russia could modernize an aging Soviet-era route. Kazakhstan could gain maritime independence. China could secure another westward corridor for trade. Few infrastructure ideas promise so much to so many. And that's why, despite political changes, financial setbacks, and shifting alliances, the concept has never fully disappeared. The proposed Eurasia Canal would stretch roughly 700 kilometers across southern Russia, following a geological corridor known as the Kumamonish Depression. This natural low-lying valley provides one of the only viable routes for such a waterway, avoiding mountains and steep elevation changes that would make construction far more difficult. The canal would be deep, around 6.5 to 7 meters, allowing ships weighing between 10,000 and 15,000 tons to pass through. That is nearly three times the capacity of the Volga-Don Canal. Cargo volume could reach between 75 and 100 million tons per year, placing the canal among the world's busiest shipping routes. Ports across the Caspian, like Aktau in Kazakhstan, Turkmenbashi in Turkmenistan, and Astrakhan in Russia, would gain direct access to the Black Sea. From there, ships could pass through Turkey's straits into the Mediterranean and onto global markets. For the inland economies of Central Asia, this would be transformative. It would turn a closed sea into a maritime trade hub and create new trade corridors linking Europe, the Middle East, Asia, and Africa. Constructing a canal of this scale would be an undertaking comparable to the Suez or Panama Canal projects. Millions of cubic meters of earth would need to be excavated. Concrete structures would rise across hundreds of kilometers, Entire towns, railways, pipelines, and road networks would be built or expanded to support construction and future logistics. But the challenge isn't simply about scale. The Caspian Sea lies 28 meters below sea level. The Black Sea does not. This means water will not naturally flow along the route. Engineers would need to build a series of sophisticated locks and pumping stations to regulate water levels and stabilize the flow. These systems would work much like those used in the Panama Canal, but on a scale adapted for larger and longer cargo vessels. Soil conditions present another challenge. Much of the terrain is dry and prone to erosion. To prevent banks from collapsing and salinization from damaging farmland, the project would require extensive reinforcement, water balancing basins, and irrigation management systems. Modern navigation systems would be integrated into the canal, allowing ships to travel in two-way lanes guided by real-time tracking and automated control. At peak construction, tens of thousands of workers could be employed across multiple work fronts, with the project spanning 10 to 15 years. The biggest challenge isn't engineering, it's funding. A project estimated at over $20 billion comes with enormous financial and political risk. Russia is interested, but its economy is strained and under sanctions. Kazakhstan supports the canal, but cannot fund it alone. China remains the most likely investor, given its experience with megaproject construction and its interest in strengthening Eurasian trade routes. Through state banks and Belt and Road partnerships, China has the capacity to finance and build infrastructure on this scale. But geopolitical tensions, shifting alliances, and the long payback period make investors cautious. No one wants to commit until the long-term benefits are undeniable. Geopolitics complicates everything. Iran and Azerbaijan worry that a new canal would give Russia even more influence over Caspian trade. Turkey, which controls the Bosporus and Dardanelles, the narrow straits every ship must pass through to reach the Mediterranean, would still hold the final gate. Even if the canal opens the Caspian to the Black Sea, Turkey remains the doorkeeper to the wider world. There are also questions about trade volume. Oil and gas increasingly move by pipeline. Markets are shifting. Critics argue that the canal is a politically driven dream rather than an economic necessity. Supporters say it is a long-term investment, one that could shape the region for centuries, not just decades. Environmental concerns may prove decisive. Diverting rivers and altering natural waterways can disrupt delicate ecosystems. Fish migration routes could be blocked. Wetlands could dry up. Salt levels could change, damaging farmland and accelerating desertification. Plans call for artificial reservoirs, controlled flow gates, and fish passages designed to protect wildlife. But history shows that once water systems are altered at this scale, the consequences are difficult to predict and nearly impossible to reverse. The environmental debate remains one of the most serious obstacles to the project. As of 2025, the Eurasia Canal remains in the planning and feasibility stage. Detailed engineering studies are ongoing. Negotiations continue. If funding and political agreements align, construction could begin later this decade. Completion would likely be in the late 2030s or early 2040s. Supporters believe this canal could transform the Caspian region into a maritime powerhouse. Critics see a grand vision that may never leave the drawing board. The truth is that mega projects like this depend not only on engineering or economics, but on timing. And timing may yet determine everything. If built, the Eurasia Canal could stand alongside Suez and Panama as one of the great waterways of history. It could reshape trade networks, redefine regional power, and open the landlocked heart of Eurasia to the sea. But for now, it remains a bold idea, a vision suspended between ambition and reality, a future that waits for its moment.